Welcome to the sea, motherfuckers. The pimp.
What up?
And Barry Blaze are back. Oh, I did that backwards. So it does not sound right doing it that way. But yeah, we took a slight hiatus because. Nah, did we even take a hiatus?
No.
We're just a day late.
Yeah,
hold maybe 2 days, a little more. Yeah. It's finals week in the Jew college town. I've been busy. Braden seems a little busy too. But we coming back, baby. Jew will be home next weekend, and then we going strong. This is going to be the summer of the sea.
You ever have a girl like fart on a boner?
Every time I turn on the sea podcast, it's all that happens. My whole house turns on the boner farts.
Girls just fart on boners at your house?
We have that effect on people.
I like it.
That's how hard you're a girl watching the sea. Huh?
That's a hard effect to get on people.
Yeah.
What were you going to say, though? If you're a girl watching the sea, what?
If you're a girl watching the sea, comment if you farted on a boner today or not.
Yeah.
For real.
Mm-hmm. So, do you ever, when you're using, like, a GPS and something comes up, like, hazard ahead, is it still there? Or, like, speed check ahead, is it still there?
Yeah.
Do you tell the truth there?
I never click anything. Oh. I just let it stay on my phone till it goes away. But it's been wrong more times than it's been right.
Yeah. Well, probably because of people like me. I just spread misinformation on it, dude. If it's like you speed check ahead, is it still there? And I pass a cop, I just hit, nope, not there anymore.
Can you like, how do you even get those popping up? Like, can you go on your map and be like, cop?
Yeah, you push like report incident and that gives you a bunch of different ones to push. So you do like speed check or like a hazard. Yeah.
I'm going to start spamming that, dude.
I think it only will show up on other people's though if it like pulls enough of the same data. If like a certain amount of people in that same area around that same time are hitting it, it probably takes it seriously.
But like, yeah.
Would be my guess.
Okay.
But I'm not too sure. I'm going
yeah.
High camera angle here. You're going to see my eyes today.
I can only see your eye. You look like ninja bees. Barry
yeah,
ninja.
It's the vibe I want Barry today, dude. I'm off a monster. I just took some blinkies off the cart.
Blinkies!
Off the Benjamin. And life's going good. Life's never been better.
Like it. I like it. I had so much stuff this week that I was like, oh, I'm going to talk about this on the pod. But then didn't write it all down. I was thinking like, I need to write it down too. And then I just didn't do it.
You got to write it down, man. But I also didn't write like, how do you think this week?
Yeah, I had some good talking points, dude.
I think it's good when we just kind of free flow.
Yeah, I got really hammered last night. And you know when you get like too hammered, like maybe you do a little bit of 5 hour energies, you know? And then you just like, you're too drunk, you just start doing like hearts to hearts with people. You're like, oh dude, I fucking love you, bro. I just feel like it's so gay. I feel like it's the gayest thing in the world. But I do it all the time. Like if I get too hammered, I'm gonna be like, oh dude, you're an awesome fucking guy, dude. You're my homie. I love you, man. And I'm just like, why do I tell all my friends that I like them when I'm fucking
yeah, it's like, out? Obviously, you're getting drunk with them right now.
Yeah, but then I wake up in the morning,
of course,
and I feel bad about that. Like, I wake up in the morning, and I'm like, damn, dude, I sounded like a faggot. Like, made all those people feel good about themselves, dude. What the fuck is wrong with me? Like, I actually woke up this morning, like, with a slight embarrassment, like, why'd I compliment everyone? They didn't deserve it. I'm just kidding. They deserved it. They deserve
it. No, they don't. They don't.
No. No.
I'm just kidding. But I gotta stop. I don't know. I always, what are you doing? Hold on. My little sister is interrupting.
Charlotte!
She can't hear you. What are you asking me, though?
Whoop, whoop, whoop.
Why are you dancing? You can't even hear him, can you?
You know, let her get her snippet on the pod.
Can you hear?
Let her get
Ben?
Some words in.
Oh,
hey,
come here real quick.
Yeah.
Shut the door, though. Well, hold on. Well, hold on. Wait to ask the question.
Yeah, I can't.
All right, ask the question.
Brother, did you poop in the toilet?
Me no. Or Brady?
Why?
Liar.
Why?
Liar, it stunk so bad.
Oh, I did poop in the toilet.
I know it stunk.
Barry Blaze came to my house once and he pooped and he left like a huge stain on the back of my toilet.
Wait, say that again. She couldn't hear you.
Yeah, I couldn't hear you.
Yeah, no, Brayden came to my house once and he went to the bathroom and I went to go pee in there right after him and he shit like on the whole back of the toilet. Like the whole back of the toilet was just covered in his poop streaks.
Yeah, it's so bad.
Yeah.
Guys, I take. I'm a heavy hitter, bro.
But no, I can't do that with a mirror because brother decided he needed to poop.
Okay, well, that I'm a heavy hitter, guys.
You gotta start aiming your butt right.
What?
You gotta start aiming your butt in the toilet, right?
Do you like, there's no, that was not like human.
Okay.
That was a human.
I didn't know you were coming in here to judge my poops. Alright, skedaddle. Okay, stop hitting me. All right, get out of here. Go. Go. You're making him bar work. Stop. Don't. It's Craig.
All right, Charlotte. Are your snippets over?
Yeah, your snippets are over. Saying you're welcome here. This is Craig. Yes. Yes.
Yeah, I can't hear.
Craig doesn't talk. Yeah, no one can hear you right now.
Yeah, oh, I can only gag because the microphone's too far.
I was confused who the bear was.
The point of the microphone is you don't have to yell.
Yeah, God. I think if you talk too loud in it, it like cuts off her voice.
Yeah.
Because I couldn't hear what you said.
All right, go. Stop. You've overstayed your welcome.
Yep. She's just going crazy, dude. Give him a smack. Smack on the back of the head.
Don't smack me again.
Smack him, Charles.
She's already
smacking Charles. Yeah.
Ow.
Yeah.
Get out of here. You're making Theo freak out. That's bad audio.
Alright.
Alright, go. Oh my god. Theo doesn't do anything when she's smacking me, but if I even like go near her, oh, I guess he doesn't care anymore. Actually, yeah, he's like, shit her, dude.
See, in my family, it was the opposite. I would walk into Megan's room and just start smacking her.
Yeah,
that's how it'd be.
But she couldn't do the same.
No, she did. I would steal her vape. Nice. I remember there was.
Hold on. Charlotte, skedaddle. Thank you for coming on. All right.
But yeah, did you ever...
Shut the door. Please. Shut the door. Why are you doing this to me?
Yeah, and we might need to cut some of that. I can see her peeking.
Yeah, Charlotte.
Yeah, Charlotte. We might need to cut some of the Charlotte intervene.
I'm gonna cry. Get out!
No, okay, no.
Oh my god, Brayden is just beating up his little sister right now. He just broke her nose, dude. Oh my god, he's kicking her while she's down. He's kicking her while she's down. Bia.
What?
What? You can't just beat up a little person like that, dude. You just stomped on her, dude.
She wouldn't leave, bro.
That's fucked up, bro.
You cannot lie to just suck up. You know how many people want to be on this podcast, dude? You can't just like take over the pod like that.
Yeah, you can't take over our pod. That was the first attempt of someone taking over our pod, dude. And not gonna lie, Bia, I feel like you could have done a little better there. The violence should have came out early. The violence should have came out early, dude.
I gave her a chance to leave.
Nah, I'm kidding though. But you ever take your power over your little sisters? Like, oh, they got a little vape, huh? I would be like, yo, what's up, little sister? Give me your fucking vape.
No, she did that. Like, sister's 12.
Yeah, my sister was too.
No, she wasn't.
Dude, she was 12 vaping.
Megan?
Yeah.
What a pimp.
Threw her a little vape.
Threw a little vape here and there.
Yeah, my mom got mad at me, but I was like, dude, what? I'm not going to stop. How am I going to stop her? Yeah, and she was just like 12. She had no access to vapes except like going through my drawers in my room and like stealing them.
I mean, it's like you versus Big Tobacco. Who's really going to win that fight, dude?
Yeah, for real.
Like you, like there's not even, it's pointless.
For real.
I say let the kids vape.
I can't believe on the last pod too, we were trying to think of like good stories to tell and we were like stuck. We got so many good ones, bro. We got so many good ones.
Well, then what?
I forgot.
I just blank. I blank but every time.
I know. I was thinking all week though. I was like, damn, I got to tell this one, dude. This one would have been perfect for the pod. And I was like, oh, I could tell this one. And then I just fucking keep forgetting, dude.
Well, anything eventful in the last week?
Like, new eventful things?
How do you feel about the draft?
I like it. I like Terrion Arnold, dude.
Nah, so he's a scrub.
I thought we were going to get Kool-Aid.
Did he even get picked yet?
Yeah, he got picked, like, a little bit after our pick. Mm-hmm. But yeah. I guess this guy's like the best corner in the draft or something. He was like one of the best corners in the draft and he was projected to go top 10. And then no one took him, so we traded up to get him.
And you guys will fail to develop him and they'll leave.
Yeah, I dude.
Darius.
Oh, who the Packers pick, huh?
We got a sick linebacker and a good offensive tackle to protect the love.
Yeah.
I'm kind of scared about them,
dude.
I'm kind of nervous about the Bears, though. I won't lie.
Really? What's so nervous about the Bears, dude?
They got DJ Moore, Keenan Allen, DeAndre Swift, Caleb Williams. Yeah.
What about Minnesota,
so young,
bro?
Besides
Minnesota's sick, too.
Nah.
No?
I don't know. I want McCarthy to be good, but I don't think he will.
Really?
The Vikings, for whatever reason, just fumble the bag every time.
Yeah, if Jefferson doesn't get injured, though, this season, it could be a good one.
Yeah, but he wants out? He wants to go play with Ja'Marr Chase and Joe Burr.
Really?
Yeah.
That would be too stacked, dude.
No, that would be awesome. That's what everybody thought that Odell and Landry would have been in the Browns. Do you remember when they played together?
Yeah, I thought they were going to be crazy too. And they would just kind of sucked, right?
Yeah, but they had horrible kind of offense besides them.
Didn't they have Baker? And then
I think they got Baker after like a. I think Landry was gone by the time they got Baker.
I think Baker was there. Maybe I'm wrong though.
Whatever happened to Landry? You just die.
Yeah, he got too old.
But he same draft class as Odell. Odell's still hanging.
Not really.
Yeah, true.
He's hanging by a thread, if anything. Mm-hmm. Fucking Odell. He just did it right, dude. He's like, I'm mediocre. Had one good season. And now I'm just a celebrity. Like, I bet he could pull more bitches than, like, DeAndre Hopkins.
Probably.
Yeah, I bet Odell slays way more pussy.
Have you ever seen DeAndre Hopkins' blind mom?
No, but I'd fuck. I need to fuck a blind or deaf girl. Like, that's a big goal that has to come up soon.
How would you do it? All right. Who? Blind girls at the end of the bar, deaf girls in the booth in the back. Where are you going? Who are you going to start with if presented with both?
All right. So I walk in the bar, right? I walk in. Mm-hmm. I do my, what's it called? When I like analyze the place, you know what I do when I walk in the bars, right?
Yeah, the flu scan.
I do my scan. Yeah.
Yeah.
And then, shoo, I scan. I notice something.
That's pussy.
First, I notice a girl at the bar. I'm like, okay, shit. And I see the hot girl. Wait, which one's deaf? Which one's blind?
Blind girls at the bar, deaf girls in the booth in the back.
Both hot.
Oh, amazing.
Okay, yeah. So I see them both. I walk up to the girl at the bar. And I'm like, yeah. What's up, shawty? Your eyes look beautiful. I'm going to tell her that off the bat.
You're saying this to who?
The blind woman. And then
you're
I'm going to be
tell
like.
Tell the blind woman her eyes are beautiful?
Yeah.
But you can't.
And then I'm going to be like, yo. And
like, okay, wait. So the one icebreaker, you're immediately just going to like bring up her eyes to the blind girl?
Yeah. Wait, just wait for it.
All right, run it.
I look at the bartender, I'm like, hey, double shot, tequila.
Boom. No, wait, start over. We walk up to the blind girl.
I walk up to the blind girl, I'm like, hey, I like your eyes, shawty.
And I've never seen them before. Are they pretty? What color are my eyes?
Just a minute, sweetheart. Hey, yo, bartender, two double tequila shots right here.
I drink wine.
Good. These were for me, bitch. All right. Boom. You got to go to the bathroom, right? You got to go to the bathroom at one point.
Me?
I wait around till you got to go to the bathroom. Yeah.
Oh. Okay. Right, here, right. So I bust out my cane.
Go.
I bust out my cane and I walk to the bathroom.
Say like, oh, I have to go to the bathroom.
Oh, hold on. Let me get my cane out. I got to go to the ladies' room.
Why do you have a cane?
Because I'm blind.
Okay, just wait. Oh, yeah. You're right.
My little stick.
All right, yeah. Go to the bathroom.
Yeah. Oh, excuse me.
Pardon me. Oh, yeah, all right. Oops. Boom. I scan. Ooh, see the girl at the booth. Notice she's deaf. I walk up. I pull out my sign language. And I'm like, hey, how you doing?
I can read lips.
My sister is in the bathroom. All right? She's coming out in a minute, but she's delusional. And for some reason, every time I take her to a bar, she thinks that she's like a girl that I'm hitting on and not my family member. Crazy, right?
That's very weird.
Yeah, boom. Blind girl comes out of the bathroom. Sees me sitting with the deaf girl. I'm like, hey, come here, shawty.
Oh, wait, am I the blind girl now?
Yeah.
Wait, where's that coming from? Hello?
Hey, over here. Over here, dude.
Okay, I'm coming. Hold on. Do you guys see the guy yelling at me? Will you escort me to him? Oh, thank you. Well, hi. Are you the guy
I'm gonna say,
in the bar?
Put that stick under the table.
Oh. I don't really like that having the stick
put
on.
Put that stick under the table, bitch.
It's hard for me to find the stick once I set it somewhere.
Well, you'll find my stick.
Oh.
One side.
Okay. Okay.
So, right. Fuck. I don't know. I'm fumbling. I don't know where I was going with this. I'm too mixed up. I can't think on the spot right now. I'm hungover.
I liked it.
Yeah. That was decent. I needed a good closer, but
I couldn't get it. I just wanted you to answer which one you would go for first.
Well, obviously the blind one, because then I send her to the bathroom and I go sit with the death girl. She doesn't even notice. I'm making out with the death bitch. Go to fuck the blind girl. Boom, boom, boom. That's like a crazy... If there was a blind girl and a deaf girl at the same bar, I'm going home with both. And they're not going to know.
Well, the deaf girl can see.
Well, how hard is it to cheat on a deaf girl?
Well, I guess she just thinks it's your sister.
Yeah. Okay, a deaf girl who can't read lips, and you're like banging, like you're cheating on her, and her friends are trying to tell her, but she doesn't, her friends don't know sign language.
No, so what you do you had the right idea at the start. You go, you find the blind girl, you send her to the bathroom. You go to the deaf girl, you explain, oh, this is my sister. She's very, flirtatious, just kind of her personality, whatever. And blind girl comes back. You still talk to the deaf girl or the blind girl too while you're hooking up with the deaf girl all night. But the blind girl never knows. Okay. And then you take both of them home. Deaf girl falls asleep, and then you and blind girl just have like really loud sex. She can't.
Yeah. Damn.
And then
dude. You
bag them both.
That's got to be the easiest two-girl, one-night fucking job ever. If they're blind and deaf, dude.
I saw this family on YouTube shorts about that they're, like, they're deaf parents. And one was like, what is it like living with deaf parents? And it was just, like, a bunch of, like, funny ha-ha stuff, I guess. Stuff that they thought was funny. And then, it ended with them like, oh, and we can sneak out, haha. So they go to like sneak out, and then the dad and mom are like waiting outside the front door, like, not on our watch. And it's like, yeah, you would like to think that, but they're definitely gonna just sneak out with ease.
Yeah, like so easy, dude.
Yeah, like funny YouTube short, but like if you had deaf parents, dude, like with ease, bro.
Dude, with fucking... I got narcoleptic Roy, though. And, like, you think the dude who falls asleep every 5 minutes won't get woken up or easily. That dude wakes up like a fucking... The feather drops, dude. Dude's up.
Yeah, it's like, bro, so maybe, go back to sleep, though.
Maybe the deaf people can, like, feel the vibrations of the door slowly creaking open.
Maybe.
Outrageous. Maybe I'm outrageous.
Bro, you out of pocket right now.
I'm out of pocket.
Talking that crazy talk.
Out of pocket, out of mind.
Talking that
out
crazy
pocket,
talk.
Out of mind.
So I think last week, I just completely cut that video segment where we watched a video.
Why?
Because I didn't want to sync it up because I took too long to edit it, but... We should watch, should we do a commentary track?
On what?
I don't know, but I thought it was a good bit.
I like it. I'm with it. I'm down to commentary this track.
But yeah, I don't really know of what. Should we do like a...
Oh, wait. I got a crazy idea before this.
Huh.
Fucking, I know where George works, and he doesn't want me to know.
Okay.
We can call it, and it's a hotel. Yeah. If we just fucking harass him while he's at work.
What's his job there?
He's like the desk dude. He like checks you in.
Let me call
him. And he answers the phone. Yeah. It's the Comfort Inn.
The Comfort Inn.
Yeah. The one next to Applebee's, you know?
Okay. Let me find it real quick. Why doesn't he want you to know?
Because he doesn't want me to do this kind of shit.
I guess that's
and
fair.
I found out last night because someone saw him type in his phone password, and they put it in their notes and they sent it to everybody. And then last night we went on his phone, and we just like started like snooping through all his shit, which is a little fucked up. Which is a little fucked up. But we're like, oh, like, let's see how George like flirts with girls, and it's so bad. It's like cringe as hell, dude.
What's his game like?
He's like, oh, I was really hoping to see you tonight. Because the girl was like, oh, I'm kind of busy. I gotta hang with my grandma. And then he like he double snapped her at like 1 a.m. And I couldn't see what it was. It was just like him. Like, he's being too simp, you know?
Yeah.
Bending over backwards for the bitches.
You doing tricks on it?
Yeah, but then we just started posting shit on his story. And he woke up in the morning and he was like, hey, Ben, you want to get breakfast? And I'm like, yeah. And I'm like, I go on like Instagram and I see everything is still up. And he like has not noticed yet. And I'm like, dude, what's on your story, bro? And then he like freaked out. But that's how I found out where he works.
Oh, damn. Okay.
Yeah.
Is he there right now?
Yeah, because he went to fucking work after we got food.
Alright, well, should I just like act like I'm gonna like be getting a room?
Yeah, and then go like, wait a minute. Are you that something? Because cops were after him, but they couldn't prove it.
Okay. You think you'll recognize my voice?
Go like, dude, say you're a detective. Like FBI or something, and go like, yeah, so we tracked these fingerprints that we got. Well, actually,
What if I start by like I'm gonna get a beginning a room?
Yeah,
and then I'll be like, yeah. So, what's your name, man? And then he'll give me his name, and I'll be like, oh, funny. We've been hearing that you're the dude who pulled the fire alarm. I'm actually on that case.
Think of a good detective name too, like something like French or something.
No, it's got to be like Dale Dartmouth. No.
Dale Dartmouth. I like it. That's perfect, actually. Dale Dartmouth. Dale Dartmouth. Okay. What are detectives called?
What do you mean?
I don't know.
PIs?
Like Private Eye. Yeah.
Oh, Dale Dartman. Dartmouth Private Eye.
Yeah, Bill Dartmouth, Private Eye.
All right, I'm calling.
All right, I hope he's answering the phone, dude. Is it ringing?
Can you not hear it? Oh, you can't hear that?
No.
Damn, wait, hold on. So my thing might not be loud enough.
Here, should I try to call him?
Hold on, let me see. I think there's a way where I can get, like, there's gotta be a way where we can call in through like Discord, I think.
Really?
But yeah. But let me see.
Invite. It's not the invite button, I don't think.
No, it might. I think it's gonna have to be like it's probably going to have to be like an add-on, but...
Oh.
I think...
Here. I'm going to give it a call, though, just to see if he's answering, so we don't spend too much time on this if he's, like, not even the guy answering the phone.
Yeah, start that.
So I'm going to call him and not say anything.
You can't do it anyway. So here, see if you can just put the microphone closer to the speaker and see if...
He'll definitely be able to hear you if I'm on speaker. Okay.
And then I'll make sure your thing lights up, because I don't know why my phone shouldn't be that quiet. I put it up pretty close.
All right, bet. Let's see how this works. Look how I'm setting it up.
Okay. Yeah, I like it. Are you just using your phone number? They might have caller ID.
Really?
Yeah. Just star 67'd it.
Okay, bet.
It's a pretty easy number. It has the same phone number.
Can you get the phone number up? I can just type it in.
Yeah, I have the phone number right here.
All right. Tell me.
Star 67.
Yeah.
906. 379
9000. Here we go.
Thank you for calling the Comfort Inn in Sault Ste. Marie.
Oh, yeah, that's good. That's really loud.
Press 1. For the front desk or all of your inquiries, please press 2.
Thank you for calling the Comfort Inn. This is Bert. Please have my sister.
Hey, I was just looking to book a room for later this weekend.
Hey, give me 1 second. And you were looking at the room for tonight or... Tomorrow night.
Through Tuesday.
Tell him to hurry the fuck up. Like, be mean.
Okay. Hello?
Hello? Just give me 1 second. Computer's loading. Okay,
tell him hurry the fuck up.
So it looks like, for...
Yeah, we can just, you know, hurry it up, though.
Okay, were you looking for a queen or a king or...
probably a queen.
Okay,
I get two queens, though. I want to push, like, the beds together.
Okay, yep, those are two queens together, so...
I also like to like bounce back and forth.
Would that be perfect for you? Would the two queen be good for you? Like the two queen beds?
Yeah, no, that would be perfect.
Dad, what's a good first name?
Dale.
D-A-L-E?
Yes, sir.
The last name?
Dartmouth.
You just spell that for me?
It's how it sounds.
Could you say that again, then?
It's how it sounds.
Okay, and what would that name, the last name be again?
Oh, Dartmouth?
Dartmouth. Okay. And then what's a good address?
Like, you need my address for to make a hotel reservation?
Correct.
Okay. Hold on. I recently just moved. Let me give it to you.
Start fucking with him a little more. Start fucking with him a little more.
Can I ask why you guys need my address?
It's okay, we'll get it when we get here, just to verify it's you for the credit card. But what's a good phone number?
Wait, let me give you a phone number. Or no?
Okay. Yeah. You need my phone number too? I got it for you.
Yep.
What was your name again?
My name's George.
Nice to meet you, man. Hold up, I'm getting it for you here. It is
248-820-3424. Okay.
So I
didn't
see you.
Got in
after I was here,
Fred. Start telling him you're a private investigator.
Oh, yeah, you
fuck, you hung up!
Oh, he hung up?
Yeah, damn.
Yeah, we shouldn't have given him his phone number.
I know.
That was a little too obvious.
That's why you should have jumped straight in like, I'm a private investigator. I know you're George Nagumo.
I want to do like a slow sweet burn, but yeah.
My bad.
No, it's all good. I liked it.
I'm surprised it was him answering the phone.
Yeah, he did well. He did pretty well.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Should I try it again or should we give it a little bit?
Nah, I think that's good. That was good.
Aw.
When did you start that job?
He got fired from a different hotel last week.
He likes being in the hotel game?
Yeah, I guess he's just been working in hotels for a while. But yeah, he got fired for no call, no show.
No call, no show, and they just fired him?
Yeah, and then he went to the next hotel like 2 days later. He got a new job quick, dude. He was fast with it.
I respect that.
I got this energy drink, though, and it fucking has 200 milligrams of caffeine, I guess, and then something, choline, 200 milligrams of choline. I drank a third of this last night, and it gave me a heart attack almost. I was in bed like, but now I'm like, I don't know, feeling better.
That's good.
Got my eggs salad.
Hey, yo, look at that boy.
Look at me. Look at me.
How's that egg salad?
I'm not eating it yet. I got to put mayo and mustard in it.
Beautiful.
Yeah. Never made egg salad before, but I'm hyped.
Well, now I kind of want to do a prank call where we just, like, start some drama. Like, not drama, like, but, like, just beef. Like, we're just assholes.
That's what I wanted you to do with George, kind of. Like, hey, fuck you. Hurry the fuck up, kid. And, like, because he's so, like, non-confrontational, he would, like, shit himself.
Damn. Okay, we'll give it, we'll do it next week, too.
No. I say we call him back right now and we fucking get aggressive.
It's like, you hang up on me, fucker? Like,
you hung up on me, bitch?
Okay.
All right.
Call him back.
Yeah. All right, good. Do you have it in you right now? Can you be pissed off?
Yeah.
All right, bet. Star 6-7.
Wait, where'd my camera go?
Yeah, I don't know. What? What just happened to you? I looked down for 1 second.
I don't know. I'm still here, though, but that's weird.
Yeah, I guess we don't really. Do you see me, at least?
Yeah.
All right, bet. All right, we're calling back.
What is that?
I don't know. It's tweaking.
Is he Greg a hacker, man?
He actually is.
What? Is he hacking in the sea right now?
No, that would be crazy. He's at work, dude. He can't hack at work.
Bro, that's never stopped any hacker man in the history of hacker man.
Yeah, that's
true. But they're lethal, man. They can be anywhere. The GTA guy did it. They locked him in a hotel room. With, like, nothing in there besides, like, a Roku.
Calling the comfort.
My bad. But they did that to that fucking guy?
Yeah.
All right, here.
And my camera just went out? Is he, like, watching us right now? Did he take over my camera?
He might be. Like, I hope he's not hacking.
Hey, man, I just got a question. Why'd you hang up on me?
Yeah,
I was the guy you just hung up on? Dale?
He hung up fast. Alright, maybe it won't work.
Why is he hanging up, though? Wait. Stop. Can you hear me? I can't hear you. But can you hear me? No, wait, your audio is fine. Wait, are you muted? I can't hear you. Yeah, your light's not going on either. Is George hacking the sea right now? Is he hacking the sea right now? I don't think your audio is going, so I'm just going to keep trying to fill in the dead space right now. That's really weird. Hold on. Let me make sure it's not going to my headphones. Give me 2 seconds here.
No, is it working?
Oh, I can hear you now.
I turned off my microphone. Now it's my computer mic.
That's weird. Can you still hear me?
Yeah.
No, but now it's breaking up.
Breaking up.
What about now?
Now it's good, but now you're frozen, dude.
Yeah, now I'm on my mic.
Yeah, but you're...
I'm frozen on my screen too.
What? Is he hacking the sea?
Dude, what the fuck is he doing?
What the fuck is this?
Am I back?
Dude? Yeah, you're back. Okay. Did you put it on your mic?
Yep. On the mic.
Okay. That was weird.
Here, turn your camera on and off and see if that does anything.
I did do that. Oh, nope. I don't know.
Dude,
that's weird.
We didn't even press any buttons, dude, and then my microphone went out the same time your camera goes out.
Well, right after I hung up the first time, my camera went out, and then after we hung up that time, your mic just went out.
Should we call him one more time and see if he's doing this?
Are you hacking us, you fuck? I don't want to see what's next, dude.
He's going to be mad if we do a third phone call for sure.
Yeah, we can't double that. But comedy does come in threes, bro. All
right, we're doing it.
So you fucking hacking me?
And after you call them a third time, they either think a shit ton more is coming and they like don't know what to do. Like two times might be like, oh, whatever. But if you do it a third time, they might call me again.
Yeah, they're like, okay, we got to handle this because it's just going to keep happening.
Yeah, exactly. All right, let's do it.
Thank you for calling the Comfort Inn in Sault Ste. Marie. For new reservations, please.
Thanks for calling Comfort Inn. This is Randy. How can I help you? I'll show you again.
Hello.
Hi.
I've been trying to book a reservation, and I just keep getting hung up on.
You keep getting hung up on? Oh, my goodness. Okay, I wonder if you've been reaching us or not, because the phone hasn't really rung. When are you trying to book for him?
Sunday through Tuesday.
Sunday through Tuesday, so the 28th through, it looks like, the 30th.
Yes.
And then are you with any companies that would have a rate with us or no?
No, not that I'm aware of.
Just tonight. Okay. Because we want to check out Tuesday morning, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So the rate that I'm looking at right now for...
So I just hang up on this?
I'm sorry. Are you driving?
Yeah.
All right, she hung up.
Okay.
Yeah, I hung up. Damn. Okay,
wait, it went to my camera. On my phone.
Yeah, I was wondering, how the fuck did you do that, dude?
Dude, I don't know, but it scared me when I saw just this. I thought Greg was, like, George in his office like, or something, like, being like, I gotcha. Dude, that's kind of sick. My room's messy, but my hair's all greasy.
Yeah,
dude, but...
you're Discorded, and then it went on your phone camera? What the fuck?
I don't know. I've never seen... Oh, I guess it does say connecting to Mac. Maybe I hit it. I don't know. That's weird, though. But I want to.
It's kind of
okay.
Cool.
It is kind of cool, but I don't want it to go to my computer. All right, so. Damn, I just don't want to get him in trouble.
Yeah.
If he just got fired.
I thought you were about to be like, yeah, this George guy keeps fucking up, dude.
No, I wanted to. I was like ready to just like fight with Greg. So when she answered, I was ready to keep it going. But then I was like, I don't want to get him in trouble.
Yeah. Damn. Well, but he is a menace, though. Like, he takes my phone and he calls you and says he wants to suck you off and shit.
Yeah.
Like, he deserves this, of all people.
That is true.
Do you think he's tweaking out? Should I tell him it was me, or should I just tell him it wasn't?
No, just never bring it up.
Never bring it up?
Unless he doesn't speak. I don't know what you're talking about.
Damn, I'm kind of bullying this kid now that I think about it. We fucking posted a shit ton of stuff on his story last night. Calling him gay and stuff. And then we prank call his work all the next day.
Yeah, well, that's just good old-fashioned fun, dude.
Yeah, good old-fashioned fun. He keeps asking me if he can order a ton of pizzas to your house, so I keep telling him he can't.
Oh, I will just order a bunch of pizzas to his house.
He doesn't have a house.
Where does he sleep?
He migrates.
Oh. Well, fuck him, dude. You're yeah, just sending pizzas to people's house when you don't even have a house.
Yeah, his best friend blocked him. Like, what? he's really sad about it.
Was it Greg? Ordered,
like, no, it's some dude from back home. Oh. Like, in his hometown. It's like if I went to college and then I ordered, like, 10 pizzas to your house in 1 week, and then you just kept telling me stop, and I just laughed, and then you blocked me.
Oh, so, wait. So he's learned nothing, though.
He's learned nothing.
So, like, you can't even feel bad.
Yeah, exactly.
He lost his best friend, and now he's a migrant, and he still wants to be like, but I gotta order some pizzas to this dude.
Yeah.
What are his priorities right now?
I feel like he just can't help it. He can't help it, dude.
Have you ever seen The Purple Llama?
No.
That's the one I was talking about in that episode where I took a bunch of edibles solo.
Yeah, and you were just looking at Purple Llama or something?
Yeah, absolutely. I just put a picture in it, but I made this.
Yeah, I was going to say, did you paint that?
Yeah.
It looks really good.
It's the Fortnite llama. I didn't even realize it. That's the funny part. I, like, subconsciously just made the Fortnite llama.
Well, like, the stripes.
Yeah, the stripes and the coloring. I don't know if they're... I think they're, like, green stripes, but I think the coloring and, like, the white stripes on the neck, I, like... And the purple.
Like, the green llama. The green llama. I mean, no. The pink llama should be a fucking thing for the sea, dude.
That's what I'm saying, bro.
It should be like our... It should be like our fucking face, dude. Yeah, it does kind of look like the fucking Fortnite pinata.
Yeah. Loot llama.
Loot llam.
So, like, that's just what my subconscious created.
I like it. I honestly, if it looked more like that, I think they would look way cooler.
Pretty swaggy, isn't it?
It is a swaggy llama.
Yeah. No, I'm not going to put that... What?
Did you clay make that?
I didn't make the clay. I just painted it.
Yeah. I was going to say, if you made the clay too, that's fucking... That's got to be crazy hard. Like, how do you even do that?
Ain't nothing for a pimp like me, man. Me and Charlotte and Callie are making a stop motion movie about it's called Mr. Poop.
What's the stop motion mean?
Like, you know, like claymation type shit, pretty much. Nothing. Ringing a bell. I can't figure out how to describe it to you right now, but basically, like, you're taking something like if I took the llama.
Okay, you move it like an inch every time and then you take a picture.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like what fucking iCarly Spencer did it.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know what you're talking about. That's still a thing, dude.
Yeah, it's still a thing. I'm going to do. Do you want to hear the intro?
Yeah, run it up. Put some emotion into it.
No, I'm just going to send you it. I need you to play because my phone's not going to be loud enough.
Is it like a video or is it like a script?
It's just the intro to Mr. It's the theme song to Mr. Poop.
Mr. Poop?
Yeah.
Bet.
Wait, hold on here. Let me find it, though. Yeah, you know how, like, some songs have theme songs?
Some songs have theme songs?
Fuck off. I meant, like, you know, some shows have, like, theme songs.
I feel like every show has a theme song. If I turned on a TV show and it didn't have a theme song and just went right into everything, I'd be a little, like, concerned.
All right, like, so now look at now play that? It. I just sent it to you. Play it for the podcast, too. I want to get your thoughts on it.
All right, bet. Are we just going to, like, edit in the clip? Oh, no, it's an audio file.
It's just audio. It's just the song.
All right, ready?
We have to make it still.
You flushed me down the drain. Now the sewer's where I remain.
Callie. And I'm Poop. And I'm Brayden.
let me play that back real quick.
Alright, yeah, I don't
you
know.
You flushed me down the drain. Now the sewer's where I remain.
Callie. And I'm Poop. And I'm Brayden.
The I'm Brayden get hits hard too.
I think the beat drop goes hard too.
I like the. Here, one more. I like how you got Theo in there too.
Of course, we got Theo in there, dude. That was Charlotte's choice, though.
Uh-oh.
I can't take good credit ball. For that. She picked up the audio for that.
She didn't even say, I'm Charlotte. She just said, Charlotte.
Yeah.
Callie said her name three times.
Yeah. I didn't
what
think
is the,
my.
What did the beginning say?
You flushed me down the drain. Now the toilet's where I remain. Or now the sewer's where I remain. And then it says, I'm. And then it cuts to Charlotte. Callie. Well. But
right.
I maybe should have deepened it too much. Cause maybe, or maybe I should have turned it up a little bit more. But. Whatever.
Should I send it to my mom? No context.
Yeah.
The fuck.
Yeah. But
should I send it to your dad? No context.
No. Do not.
That would be funny as shit.
That would be funny, but no.
I won't. Oh.
Your mom getting it would be funny. Yeah. She'll just be like, "What the fuck?"
Are you actually making the stop motion?
Yeah. So the intro is going to be someone, you know, pooping out the Mr. Poop in the toilet and flushing him down. And then he'll give the beat drop is him getting into the sewer. And then you'll meet the cast of characters. And Theo's just going
to. Are you going to move the poop around every frame?
Yeah, we made him out of like Play-Doh.
Oh, it's not real poop.
No. Do you want to see the? I have one of the characters. I have one of the. No, I don't have. Oh shit! Charlotte has the poop, but
Can we post this on the CU when it comes out?
Huh?
Can we post this on the CU when it comes out?
Oh, it's a C production. It's our first production.
Oh, fuck it. Let me be in it then, dude. What?
That's what
I'd be like the narrator.
I think it might be easier if we just like. Maybe just animate Mr. Poop.
Well, but, yeah, but no one does stop motions because they're easy. No one's like, oh, you know what?
No. I guess not animate. I guess I think I mean we should just take like pictures. Like we create Mr. Poop and then we just get like backdrop pictures online and then we just kind of like move them around in Photoshop and build out the frames.
What about Mr. Poop hentai?
Okay, we gotta end
okay,
this.
Okay, no, sorry, that was too much. But yeah, no, I
liked it. No, I just don't feel ashamed.
Fucking George just texted me. George texted me three times. My phone's blowing up.
What did he say?
He said, Ben, stop fucking with me. Actually, stop fucking with me. I will do something to you.
That's a threat, dude. Just send him 8-ball pool.
This 8-ball pool?
Yeah. Or that. But. Just know that is an aggression, though.
The pool?
If someone threatens you and you just send 8-ball pool back, that's just you being like, do it.
Should I do difficulty normal or hard?
Hard.
Let's play 8-ball. Bless, bitch.
What is he gonna do?
No, George isn't gonna do shit, dude. He does get like really mad because I just push him to the limits.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm trying to do that though, dude. The wrong person though.
Yeah, but the thing is, he pushes everyone else. He pisses off everybody. But you know, I'm me, dude. I'm the king. No one can top me. And him doing it to everybody makes me feel like I can go over the limit with him. Like, oh, I can do stuff to George that I want to do to other people, but I can't because they would punch me.
Yeah, but
so I do all that to George, and I really go, I take it all out on him. I like walk in a room, start talking about his mom, and then I just like choke him out. And then I'm like, dude, you're a bitch, dude. And then I grab his dabs, dude. I'm like, you broke my phone. So every time he brings dabs in the house, I just grab them from him. And I'm like, these are my dabs. I give them back, but I just take like a fat dab every time.
Mm-hmm.
And then he calls me and he's like, you want to get free food? And then I'm just like calling him ugly and gay the whole time. And I'm like, damn, I can't control myself either. Like, it's all friendly. It's all fun and games. But then I'm like, I realize he's getting mad at some point. So then I just like,
mm-hmm.
Don't stop.
He just brings that out a bit in you.
No, I do it to every. I do it to you, dude. You get majorly pissed sometimes, dude.
Yeah. That's fair.
I do things to him that you would like immediately be like, "What the fuck?"
Well, I mean, he did break your phone that one time. And you want to know what? I laugh when I think how I once saw paradise as a realm outside the world of birth. It is the right in the world of birth and death that the miraculous truth is revealed. But this is not laughter of someone who suddenly acquires great
poetry, bro. What's this poetry about?
Neither is the laughter of the one who has won a victory. It is rather the laughter of one who, after painfully searched for something for a long time, finds it in the morning in the pocket of his coat.
Is this the Art of War 2?
No, I don't think so.
Oh, what the fuck are you reading?
I don't know, I just came from the heart, man.
No, it didn't.
Did you see the story post I did about you?
You made a story post about me?
Yeah, I explained why the pod was delayed.
What?
It's the last two posts in life. But start with the second to last one first.
Okay.
But yeah, it's not like dogging on you. I just thought it was a funny way to be like, hey, pod's delayed.
My co-host posted that last story.
No, look at the one before that, though.
Okay. Met this wild fucker last night at the local pop-up carnival. Let's just say pod delayed until tomorrow.
And then the next one.
My co-host posted that last story. I haven't heard from him since Tuesday. This was the last picture he sent me. Not sure what's going on, Barry Blake.
And then I gave a little tease for that's coming tomorrow.
Yeah, but I really like this intro. This one's my favorite so far. Or is this just the same one and it's just smaller?
No, this is the one for 17. I just made it this morning. I was like, might as well just get it out of the way.
That's my favorite one. I like that intro a lot. Damn. Were people liking the story post?
I think everyone was really concerned and confused.
Really?
Because the one gutterball guy liked the first one and then like did not like the crackhead one. So I think he thought it was a joke and funny, and then he saw the second one and didn't know. I don't know though.
Oh, damn, they hit us up today, too.
I know, I hit them up. We should, because I feel like we should get them on.
I'm down to get them on.
Just to maybe just fill a week or something. It's like, we know it'll just be a good episode.
Who's the person you said big fans, man? You know what I'm saying?
I want to get him on so bad. Look at his reels, dude.
I'm going to give you something to stew over. Check this one out.
This guy looks sick.
Bro, he's a fucking pimp.
Dude, George is so mad. He's still blowing me up.
He won't pull you back in 8-Ball?
He said, stop calling my workplace. Trying to reserve a room using my number, dog. What the fuck is wrong with you?
Dude, that's not us. That was Dale Dartmouth.
Should I say that wasn't me? That was Dale.
Say that doesn't sound like me. That sounds like Dale.
I know it was you, dog.
Just don't even answer him. I'm just cool down. All right, let's wrap it up. We're at an hour.
We're at an hour?
Yeah.
I thought we're 15 minutes in, dude.
How'd you think that was 15 minutes?
Dude, I don't know. I thought we were like not even halfway.
Oh yeah, no, that was an hour. Let's wrap it.
Well, we can keep going. Shit, dude. No, I guess we can. We got another 15. All right. Yeah. And we got to cut out I guess we don't need to cut it out, but there was like 5 minutes there, just Charlotte.
Emoting.
Yeah, and I couldn't. I don't think the microphone picked up like 90% of anything said during that time.
No. Besides, but I go through and I look for like big areas of dead space, so I'll catch it if it's horrible.
Yeah.
We usually don't have too much lately.
I'm excited for pod this summer, dude. I'm really going to be on my grind. It's going to be like my main focus besides. Yeah, no, it's my number one focus for the summer. And then I'm doing one class. And then I'm going to try that.
We'll go hard.
Get in the
lab. I was going to get this mixing plug-in. Because I think, do you notice it? Do you think our S's sound a little sharp?
I don't think I've noticed. I think I have noticed that we don't sound as good as all the other podcasts I listen to. But we're not that much different. They're slightly better quality. But how much money does it cost to get to that slightly better quality? Like fucking.
It doesn't. You just gotta mix it. I have freaking like $100 mixing plugins with like, I can do it. I just gotta start mixing. I gotta figure out how to, but it's gonna be different. I just did it for like instruments though, so I don't know. I gotta figure out how to do it sound good for vocals. I'm talking.
I bet you get it. I bet you got it.
I saw this one though, it was like $20 and it was to make our S's not pop as much or sound as sharp. Because when I watch clips sometimes, I'm just like, ooh. So the sounding a little. Huh?
Because like, I would know what you mean if I heard it, but I don't know what you, like, what do you mean sharp? I don't know. I don't understand. Like, do a sharp S.
Like a whistly, like, S. Like, Sally sells seashells at the seashore. So that little doesn't sound like a big deal when we're talking, but when you say it into a microphone, it really picks it up because it's like a louder frequency than what you're talking like, so it really sticks out.
Yeah.
But it might just be because of me. I don't know.
I have noticed that someone did that app where they do the frequency noise, and I was the only one who couldn't hear it for like the longest time. My ears were way worse than everybody else's in the room.
Should have. I think I destroyed my ears.
People were tweaking like, and I like could not hear it.
Yeah, but you also got some foam. You know, you also got, I feel like we did that in like a science class one time. And I feel like half the people were just capping.
Half the people were capping?
I feel like half of them had, like all the people who got up to like super advanced, like ears of a newborn. And they're like,
Yeah.
It's like, even if I heard a sound, I would never let sound hurt me.
Have you ever had your ears hurt from like a loud noise?
No.
Serious thing. My sister once got in my ear and screamed at the top of her lungs, and it hurt. Like, it made me like push me back. It hurt so bad.
Abuse, man.
Yeah. And then every time I listen to music, it's on full blast. I think someone just hello.
We popped up.
Yeah, you want to come in for the end? Shall I let Michael come in?
You want Mikey D to come in?
Michael. Dude, we prank called George's work like 7 times, dude.
No shit.
And he was freaking out, yeah. Say what's up to the sea.
Michael.
C-Nation back at it.
C-Nation. He was, we're going to tell that story about your drug dealer. Or no, we're going to prank call that drug dealer again one day.
Yeah, oh, yeah. That was great.
He's in a deleted episode. But that episode had some sick moments in it. We just had bad audio.
Agreed.
Tell him,
we need to get,
tell him something cool. Tell him something interesting that you would like. If you turned on your phone and you heard someone say that, you'd be like, what? Like, tell him something about what's going on with you.
I mean, it's the last fucking weekend we're all going to be together. Fucking, so tonight we're getting lit as fuck and just celebrating. I don't know.
Did you graduate? Are you out of here, Michael, this year?
Nah, next semester.
He graduates in December.
I was just wondering, but still. Who, that's so sad. The band's breaking up.
I know. We can get Michael sales and sampling and stuff. He's cannabis biz. Could be sick.
Yo, yo, yo.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Beer? Yeah.
Go smoke some weed.
Thought you were going to tell something crazy, like the first time you did anal or something.
It hasn't even been a first time for that yet, but when I have...
I count a dude fucking you in the ass as anal, too. Just because you're not doing the fucking, it doesn't mean it doesn't count.
Yeah, you got ain't old.
I'm just kidding. All right, we're wrapping up anyway.
All right, hit the beat.
Yeah. Actually, fucking, you want to help me with this beat?
No, Michael's got to do the freestyle.
Michael's freestyling?
Yeah, let me. I got a rap written, actually.
Yeah, we'll send you the lyrics.
Hold on.
I like getting guests doing the rap.
Wait, hold on. Wait, did I not have it? Okay, hold on. Give me like 2 seconds here. Do you guys keep the house year round too? I was wondering.
Yeah, we get the house all summer. So if you ever are going to the UP and you need a place to stay, you can stay here. If I'm not here, you can still stay. I don't give a fuck.
Hey, I got half a bagel sandwich downstairs for you.
Bagel sandwich?
Yeah, from the place Natalie's working at.
Fuck yeah, dude. Fuck yeah. Brayden, you sending these lyrics?
Yeah. I didn't write it down yet, so hold on. I'm sending it to you right now, though.
Yeah. Yeah, dude, look how pissed George was. It was so funny, dude. And he only found out because we gave him his number. He's like, oh, I need a phone number.
Oh. All right, we'll just keep this one short and sweet. But Michael, you gotta really kill it.
You gotta, yeah. I want, like, emotion into it, dude.
Let me know. Do you think this is too short, Ben? Don't let Michael see it till he has to read it. You gotta, the first time you read, like, are rapping it has to be the first time you read it. So you gotta just, no pre-reading.
Bet.
I'm never setting you up for any, like, slurs or anything, though. So don't, like.
All right, I say I like it. It's a little short, but I say he has to add on 3 bars to that himself. So, like, once you finish reading this part, you freestyle for, like, a little bit. Just a few more lines. Or Brayden might have something else.
Yeah, hold on. Yeah, I think I can add some more. I'll edit this down so it's not too much space. Hold on.
I kind of do like the ending, though. Like, if it just ended like that, it's pretty sick.
That's what I mean. It's like short and like, if he kills it, it's kind of just hard.
Bet. All right, yeah. Should I just have him wrap
this? Yeah, just go like that. And whatever, if he wants to add on and keep going, he can. If he wants to end it, then you can end it.
All right, but you ready? All right. We're going to drop a beat, and then you're just going to sing it the second I hand you the phone. Here, wait, take the mic.
Boom, 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 boom.
They say I don't got bars, bitch. I pop in the car. Bitch, fuck, NASCAR. Never done anal sex yet.
Hey, that's the scene, baby!